Alrighty then, shall we get started? And boop. So, let's take a look at what we have here. Number one, we need to start our game server. Number two, we need to open up our level editor that we was working on. And number three, we need to load the level so that we can get a good look at the error message we stumbled upon at the end of the last stream yesterday. So we have render level, then render, and then it tries to get something from the tile detail. Which means we probably forgot to add something into it. So, let's go into the level.ts file into render. And so, which element are we accessing that is a tile detail? We've got the map and the map is an array and of an array of a tile detail. So accessing something in the map is going to be a problem here. So is rendering game section. Let's take a look at our level here. This right here is just the main part of the level. And in our editor, we don't override render level or render. In our meta screen, we say that we are never rendering the game section, which is interesting. We probably want to override that and in fact, what advantage do we get from extending Metascreen? So we get this constructor. Map swapped is something we just added into it, which we can just move into the editor. And most of this, we probably don't need to worry about anyway. I guess map rendered is useful sometimes. So maybe we keep this. And if we add a variable here. Then we can toggle it here. But that's probably not going to help us with our immediate problem. It might just mean that more stuff appears on the screen before it comes up with a problem. So anyway, we know that this is coming through as false, which means start y is 0. End y is the map length. Start x is whatever the scroll position x is. And end x is that plus the visible amount plus the boundaries. So at some point, I'm guessing this line here is wrong, maybe? So let's put some logging in here to confirm that. So we've got a log message there if the row is out of bounds, and we want to continue, and if column is bigger than the row length, we also want to continue. And these need to be more than or equal to. So let's save that and see what happens. So this is saying that row length is 0, and I'm guessing it's saying it every time for every row. Okay, interesting, but in our types file, was it types? It was a different types file here. Now, what happens in to tile detail then? Because I know we had stuff in the map. of in the tiles bay. So this is where we have the exit. It's where we handle the boundaries and the air. We look up and see if there's a custom animation. Otherwise, we look up and see if there's a default animation. Otherwise, the detail stays as the default. So everything in the tiles array should turn into the tile detail. So let's jump into the index page. And here. So the first thing we are going to do is get a proper cast of this current level. So here we set the map. And when you render it here, we actually pass in the map. So what do we pass in? We just pass in this dot map. So that should be fine. Now, what I am going to do is get rid of these two logs just for now, because they will mean that we can't actually see anything else that's happening. What we want to do is add in a log of what the generated map length actually becomes, and then in our types we can add this back in. Nope, we still want the different types here. So we're going to log the tile length. And in two tile detail, we're going to log the tile detail length. So we've got lots of information there, hopefully. Ooh, did not like that. Cannot read exports of undefined. Let's just have a look. That's fine. But let's have a look at the files we've changed. Oh wait, it's in, we know it's in two tile detail. Looks like it might not like the log there. Okay, that's better, but will it break when we do the other log in that file? So, LMD tile length is 38, map length is 38. So it should be rendering some things, I guess. So it starts at 0 and goes on to map length, which is fine. So that shouldn't ever be out of bounds. Let's add these back in. Let's just do lots of logs of the values that we're using. So start X, start Y, end X, end Y. You know what, something else I'm going to do is index when we call start, it loads the title screen, and the title screen will load the that one. So instead of loading the title screen, I am going to load the editor, just so it saves a load of different steps when we're testing it. Broken the load button. I'm guessing I've put something in the level code file, level code entry. this should be in editor. Right, so now I should be able to... No? What else do I do in the level code entry? So... that key press listener should not affect it. Reset text is fine. Adding buttons. Do before leaving is not something we need to worry about. And the rest is the same. Let's build it again. Does not want to work. Okay, so let's swap it back and just make sure it works from the level code entry screen still. Oops, I did not mean to start it like that. That works just fine. More bugs. So here it's definitely saying that row length is 0. And it's for all the way up. I'm not going to catch up with this, am I? Okay, so up here. So in index, we say the map length here is this. We set the map, and then set it to be swapped, and then in meta screen, this dot map is passed to render. Now, what is happening here? Because oh, we told it it's rendering the game section, so if we comment this out, let's see what start x and end x become. So, this still tries to render to 7438. So here, before we do any of these logs, let's do the log of is rendering game section. Because this should come through as false, which means that this should be map length, and if map length here is 38, then that ties in exactly with what I'm seeing as it should be. But here, with as far as I can tell, no changes to map between those two points, map length is coming out as 0. Oh wait, hang on, col, so column. Oh, okay, that makes more sense. Well, sort of makes more sense. So let's have a look at a few of our files. Let's close down a lot of these as well. Types I'll want to keep open. And level and here. So I'm guessing it is adding a row for each of these, but not the content. So let's have a look at add map line. And while we're at it, since we have the console here, let's play around with some things. hello world dot substar 1 is exactly as I wanted it to be, and then 0 minus 1 is an empty string. Okay, so that's why. And if I do substring, still an empty string. It must be C sharp I'm thinking of that is doing what I want to do. Okay, so here needs to be 0 generated map line dot length minus 2, I think, because it's 0 indexed, so the length is out of bounds. Length minus 1 is the position of the last character. Is there anything? So the very edge of the screen should be 2 tiles wide. I guess we'll get it in here if we are a column short. Yeah, so I think we are a column short if we zoom way in. Also, that brown is just not clear at all, is it? So we've got 4. It's not showing the cursor because it's zoomed in, but you can just see here that there is 4 blocks wide, 4 characters wide, which is 1 block, and there should be 2. So I do actually need minus 1. Now, when we load it up, we shouldn't have any of those error messages. And there we go, we have our level loaded into the level editor. Amazing. It's only taken us, what, 3-4 sessions. Okay, let's get rid of some changes that we don't need to make. That log we don't need. This total screen did not work. That change didn't work. This should be in this file really, but let's just keep this change as small as possible. And we will keep No, let's remove them for now. I do like type safety, but hopefully it'll never come up again. Famous last words. And it looks like we don't actually need the should render game area section. So let's keep this as false. So our only change is to tidy up the editor access and don't need that log. Don't need this log. Fix removing end characters from map lines. Okay, so we have our map level loading in. Next up, we need to allow selecting a tile. My brain is just going slowly dead. It's just completely blank right now. I need to start writing notes to tell me what I need to do, because I can't currently hold code and ideas in my head at once. Click on tile. Add border to tile, show tile X and Y location. I set location there because I don't think I can spell coordinate right now. Show tile show tile thingy. Show tile character, show tile color, so essentially what we need is level should have the following metadata. What do we call them? Animation list. Default animations. Each tile should have the following metadata. Now, the default animation list has a tile and a color. So each tile may have the following custom. Custom animation metadata. Animation list key. So you click on the tile, you add a border to it. I don't think we actually need to show the X and Y. Show tile animation list key. Allow changing tile animation list key. That means we probably need a drop down. And or we just need to list them all. I wonder, panels are rendered every 1 scene, I think. Okay, as I was saying, I think panel is rendered every single scene. So, if, and I think it's rendering is skipped, if if it's got nothing in it. Thought I had a rendered panel here. So let's have a look in UI. Panel render. I guess I moved it all into here, right? So if items.length is 0, then return. So it doesn't get rendered. processing control clicks. This is get UI by tag. This is render controls. Happens in render level in metascreen. So yes, that does happen every single loop, which is great because we can hack it to do something that I never intended to do with it, which is to display UI over map. I wonder, so for every item we get the text, we get the size. We get whether we put borders around them. And we increase the panel size. And then we just render them all. So this may come with some problem in that we there may eventually be enough things in a panel that it overflows, because I'm about to add something I don't quite control, I guess. What I need is okay, let's hard code this for now, and then we can think of a fancy dynamic way of doing it later. So we know that we have ground and grass. And so what we need in our metascreen actually not in metascreen in editor we want? We kind of want a panel that controls the... what have I even called it? Animation list items. Okay. And we want the very last thing we do to add this UI panel. So let's do animation list item keys is a string of none. Zero, I is less than animation list item keys dot length. This dot UI panels dot not UI panels, this dot animation list item keys dot push. Items dot push new UI control the label of whatever key we're rendering and the method is going to do something like this. Can I give it a tag? Yes, I can give it a tag, which is going to be immensely helpful. Maybe. So what I need here is a reference to the thing that just got clicked. So UI control has a clicked method. Action. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to edit UI action to have a going to be a tag, but it's going to be an optional string because I'm hoping that doesn't break anything when I actually add it in. So somewhere else that adds tags, like level, in fact just level, isn't it? Panel. Here we go. Skills panel dot items dot push. So it seems to be perfectly happy there, but I will have to test it. But what I can do here is access the tag like that, and if current level instance of editor const editor equals current level as editor, and then I can add a method here. Set block animation and in fact what I'm going to do, just so it's more obvious, I'm going to just going to tag something onto the beginning. Then we immediately get rid of that out of the tag, and need to track or selected block key. Need to track what block is being selected. So if animation name is none, if animation name doesn't equal none, then this dot map dot we've lost a load of information about the map, haven't we? We kind of need to retain that. So in editor, let's make this protected and take map swapped into editor, but we will pass it in a map level tile detail. Is that what we called it? Wrong types. Where's our other types? Level map detail. Okay, so we can store a copy of the currently editing map in here. So now in the index page, which we probably closed down, okay, so parse generated map, we need to edit so that it doesn't turn level tile detail but level map detail. That's fine. Then here, we just need to, now that we've got access to our custom animations, this dot selected block key that. We set the selected block key to the animation name. Else if okay, so else it is none. If the custom animations has the selected block key, we need to remove it. So clear, I'm guessing we'll just get rid of everything, but delete. Will do nicely. Then in here, editor dot set block animation tag. Okay, we're getting somewhere. We are getting somewhere. But my brain is slowing down even more. So we need a way now of setting which block is selected. So map square clicked. Level, I think level has handle lemming click somewhere. Process lemming select, which receives most tile X, most tile Y. We'll steal that for R1. All we'll do is set the selected block key as x coordinate plus comma plus y coordinate. Hello Vanus, how are you doing tonight? So we have that bit done. We just need to cool this. So in our loop, process control clicks. It's not what we want. Okay, so if the cast is not in bounds, we process control clicks. Otherwise, we process lem select. If current level instance of editor sleepy. Yeah, I am sleepy as well. Just about able to write code, but I don't know how much longer that'll carry on for. But I feel like I am on a roll and I'm about to break some really big, heavy tasks. And if I can get that done tonight, then I'll be much more free tomorrow night. Okay, so now we've got, if it's the editor, and it is okay, so check game area, cursor is in bounds. So if it is a meta screen, which it is, it just checks the whole thing, which is fine, I guess. I think we just need to check that. Actually, we can do that when we are in the editor function. If multiple y is less than in fact, let's do due diligence. If it's more than or equal to zero, and it's less than or equal to, or less than, I should say, this dot meta map dot tiles dot length. Mouse X is more than or equal to zero, and mouse Y is less than metmap tiles. Y dot length. So that way we know it's definitely in the bounds. And when it's clicked, I guess we could do I guess maybe we don't actually need any extra information. The difficult bit will be later when we come to edit the meta information for each of these, which will be a multi-stage process, I guess. I'll have to set the animation for each one. Anyway, so we've got that happening, and when that happens, I want to I need to move this into there. And then when we set the block animation, we want to do whatever we need to do, and then clear this. So when a block is selected, the items get added to the panel, which means the panel will display the next time the vendor happens. When something within the panel is clicked, the items are cleared from the panel and it disappears. It's not exactly the most efficient way of doing it, but I could add something to a UI element to say it should display or not, which might be better. But I can't exactly be bothered with that right now. So let's check my to-do list. Click on the tile. I'm not adding the border just yet. I can do that. Show tile animation list key. Yeah, allow changing tile animation list key. Okay. I'm gonna have to change it in the actual map as well. Update. On tile animation change, I'm gonna need to update the meta map, update the map, and everything else is handled by the re-render. So we're going to track the actual X and Y of the selected blocks as well as the key. And then, okay, let's move this here. Let's move this here and just close everything else. It's better. So update the meta map, I'm doing that. Update the main map. So I guess it would be really helpful if I could move all of this into a new function. So we'll call it detail from tile. Tile is going to be a string. It's going to return a tile detail, I think. And that tile detail is the map, so okay, let's, instead of passing in tile, we will yeah, let's keep passing in tile, but also pass in Roman call. So now, when we set the block animations, Okay, so the all I need is this is getting complicated. More text. I need more text. Each tile is made up from a tile in the map and a possibly a custom animation. When changing a tile, we should be able to change the tile type. And optionally give it a new custom animation. Once a tile is selected, two buttons can be clicked. Update tile allows selecting of a tile type. Update animation allows selecting of a animation list item key. So this bit here we will add cancel to the end of it. That word does not look right. Apparently it is. If animation name equals cancel return, else if it's none, else if it's something. So all of this needs to go into the action panel. So we've got load, save, update tile, update animation. Update tile we will leave blank for now. Update animation. Can have all of this stuff put in it. Ah, that's got this. Show animation panel. Okay, that handles that. So we've got the button to show the animation panel. And I guess we can do something extremely similar for the tile panel at the moment. So the options for the tile panel are going to be in fact we can do tile air or tile ground and cancel. Okay, so we don't need this bit because we're not just do this. Okay, so we do need if tag is not undefined. Okay, so we've got those. And we don't want to set the block animation, we want to set tile option. Set tile option there. So I guess this dot metamap dot tiles selected it Y. Did X equals tile. Oh, level map is a array of strings. Equals split slice what I wanted was splice, but I guess I can do two slices instead. So slice beginning at 0, end at selected block X. End is start at selected block X plus 1. End of the string. And when we set it, start plus tile plus end beginning. Okay, so that updates the tile in the metamap. This updates the animation in the metamap. So the main map is a set of level tile details. Which means we can just update the tile straight off and... maybe we just need detail from tile. But we'll have to do it every time the tile changes or every time the animation changes. So in here, let's create a helper method. Actually, we don't need that. So, detail from tile, we pass in tile. Selected block X. Selected block Y. Other way around. Y fast, then X. This dot map Y and X as the column, the row and the column accesses equals tile detail. Then do the same thing up here. Tile equals this dot metamap dot tiles y dot splice x and x plus one. Not splice. Should work. So, update the tile, update the animation. Guess we just need to compile it and have a look at what breaks. One thing. That's an odd error. Let's try and get around that by actually assigning it to a variable. guessing it's something to do with the fact that we're accessing it through the current level. It seems to be happy with accessing the panels. Maybe it's because it hasn't been defined yet in the compile. So, say we put it down there. Nope, still doesn't like it. Hack our way around it just for the compiler. This cannot be referenced in current location. Okay, that hacked its way around. So, code, edit, go, load, save, update tile, update animation. That's slightly too long, but it also doesn't actually, oh right, we need to load it fast. Let's click on a random one. Okay, so the cursor isn't rendering when it goes below. Because technically that's not part of a map yet. Okay, let's commit what we have. So this is the map square clicked. Allow map square to be clicked in the editor. then here, what else can we commit from the editor that's fairly small? I think I just need to commit the rest of it. Add buttons for updating tile and animation. So just going to add a note to the end here. Buttons can't be clicked after map loaded for edit because the map isn't big enough to include the control button area. Let's have a look at base level because I think this actually does what we want it to do. No, that kind of assumes that the map is already the right size. But I can steal some of the code. So if I look at fill map, that just creates a blank map. But I can steal these two lines of code and row should be map dot length. So for any rows that are missing, we're just going to push all of the columns in. See if that works. Load the level, and the cursor is indeed working, so click there, update tile, and nothing happens. Okay, I think I'm going to have to leave it there. Thank you everyone for watching. There is a Discord in my profile if you want to follow some of the behind the scenes stuff and become part of the community. Follow and hit the notification thing if you want to get notified when I go live. And other than that, thanks for watching, and whatever you're doing with the rest of your day, evening, night, have a good one. See ya.